lifestyle's been freezing cold like the diamonds in they chain, no lab-grown stones. Jimmy boy, you been ballin', sit on the throne. Ain't never sold shit, clone, get your ass on. That bullshit is for the rodeo, it don't belong. Blowin' on that Jonah beat pack from the biggest bone. From Cape Town to H-Town, they hold it down. International respected, you see the crowns. Dust brothers and theme kings, we all hustlers. Been ballin' like Jimmy boy was beating customers. Cold as ice at the block, coming cop from us. Realest podcast in the world that can't fuck with us. This lifestyle we live, man, it's cold, it's cold, it's ice. Took a chance to fall, now we set the price. This lifestyle we live, man, it's cold, it's cold, it's ice. We took a chance to fall, now we setting the price. Let's play.
Yo, yo, what up, y'all? Welcome to another brand new episode, As Cold As Ice. You know what I'm saying? The world famous Cold As Ice. By the way, if you do not listen to the show on Spotify or on Apple, you probably wouldn't know that we still chart. Now, BTB was an award-winning show, and this is soon to be an award-winning show. We just getting, you know what I'm saying? We just doing warm-ups right now. Just doing our burpees right now. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, right now, Cold As Ice is charting globally. We are charting. By the way, guys, I am one of your hosts, Ben Baller, not Ben Humble, a.k.a. The Wash Lord, a.k.a. the Korean Liam Neeson. On the other side, down south, we got my man.
Jimmy the Gent. How y'all doing today? A.k.a. Jimmy Boy. H-Town's finest. Y'all know what to do. Ha!
Anyways, guys, this show is brought to you by the 8-time podcast producers of the year, the Dust Brothers, the Captains, a.k.a. my dogs, Miles Davis and Jordan Winter.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Original theme song by Illegal Kartel. By the way, guys, we are recording remotely from Hollywood and H-Town. That would be Houston, Texas. It is Friday. Man, I'm feeling good right now. We got some surprise coming for you in a second. But Jimmy, what's good with you, bro?
Man, I'm chilling, man. As you know, I'm fresh right now. I forgot my comb, you know what I mean? But as you can see, I ain't had long hair in over 20 years, you know what I mean? But I got a little new do, you know what I'm saying? What you think about that?
Dog, your hair look good, bro.
I think I might be able to go to the bank and get me a loan, though.
Hey, dog. You look like the Vietnamese Fred Flintstone right now, dog. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. This shit look good. How, bro.
Don't tell her what like I'm gonna be Rich. For Halloween, bro. Don't tell her what I'm gonna be for Halloween.
What's up, guys? This episode is brought to you by Captain Picks. All right, guys and girls, you've heard me talk about the Captain Picks, and now it is time to lock in. It is the golden era of sports. Dodgers World Series, NBA, NFL, college football, UFC, and more. Why not let your money make you more money? I personally know that there's thousands of CAA Army and that have been or currently are members of Captain Picks crew. I have a partnership, a new partnership to announce with Winnable. We now have the tech to have plays texted or emailed to you like the bat signal. Our Discord community of winners is jumping off 24/7 as well. Go to winnable.com/captainpicks. That's winnible.com/captainpicks and come make some bank with us. You deserve it. Put your money where your mind is. Oh, by the way, bro, you celebrate Halloween or nah, man?
Yeah, we celebrate Halloween, man. Definitely.
I mean, do you pass out candy in the neighborhood? You know, I know you live in the gated community, but do you pass out candy?
In my
shit?
Community, bro, they actually, they got this one street that they shut down. And so everybody goes there. It's like a party. It's like a block party. So everybody gets dressed. And on that street, they just go all out. They be throwing some crazy parties, bro. Like lit.
Yeah, dog. So. Our shit too. Our neighborhood, same thing, bro. They shut down, they shut down like two blocks. We got motherfuckers getting party buses dropping off in my neighborhood. Neighborhood is lit, bro. It'd be crazy, man. Motherfuckers be giving out full-size candy bars and everything. And so I was like, you know what? I ain't about to. And then my girl's like, stop being like that. We'll give out some shit. But yeah, you know, the funny thing is, I don't know how your kids are. Halloween is one of their favorite holidays, bro. Like next to Christmas, it's up there like that. Yep. They love Halloween, bro. Because the candy too, you know?
No, for sure, for sure. You gonna dress up for Halloween?
What, or what? Me?
Mm-hmm.
With the dress kids, up like you, motherfucker, put on some. Nah, I mean, you know what, dog? The only reason why I dressed up before was because for the kids. And like, I literally would never, you know, the fucked up part about that. I hate bringing up the old shit, but it's such a big part of my past. Mm-hmm. You know, unless Nick would get me my outfit, you know what I'm saying? Like we would dress up as a family. I just didn't want to dress up. You know, dog, I don't really celebrate shit, bro. You know what I mean? I'm a party pooper. Yeah. Like, we going to figure it out. I might put together something, you know what I mean?
Oh, definitely.
I tell you the truth, dog. I was dressing up just to get in good with my, you know what I'm saying, with the family, bro. I'm not. You about to dress up?
Usually we try to do something themed, you know what I mean? But not this year. I'm actually not even going to be in town or in the country for Halloween, bro. You know what I mean? I gotta go to Vietnam, and then I got to go to London. So the kids are going to be with their mom, so they're going to dress up.
What the fuck you going to London for?
I'm going to London because I'm going to meet up an artist out there, you know what I mean? Bring some jewelry that he ordered and, you know, turn it up, man. It's about to be a surprise. Y'all stay tuned, man.
Okay.
Stay tuned. Okay. Yes, sir.
What's up, guys? This episode is brought to you by PDS Debt. No one wants to think about debt, but the cold, hard truth of it is many of us will get deeper into debt during the holidays. Last year, half of American consumers took on debt to pay for the holidays. It's never too early to start planning to get out. And my friends at PDS Debt can help you with a personalized solution just for you. If you're making payments every month on your debt and your balances aren't going down, PDS has solutions for you. Everyone with $10,000 or more in ineligible debt qualifies, and there's no minimum credit score required. Bad and fair credit is accepted. Save more while paying off your debt in a fraction of time. PDS is the best solution for you. Start planning today. Get a free debt analysis right now. It only takes 30 seconds. That's pdsdebt.com. P as in Paul, D as in David, S as in sex, D as in David, E as in Eric, B as in Ben, T as in titty.com/cold. pds.com/cold. In current news, if you're watching this right now, you might be watching it in the morning tomorrow on Saturday. But as you know, if you're watching this show live, then you know that the World Series is going down right now. My LA Dodgers versus the New York Yankees. It has been a very long time. It's been decades since this shit has happened. Last time was sometime in the early 80s, I think, Fernando Valenzuela. But in 78, we lost the Yankees. And this is how old I am, man. 1978, my mom and dad took me to the motherfucking game because my mom used to work for this Italian fucking outfit dude. Mm-hmm. If you don't know what an outfit is, I ain't gonna say the other word because the other word incriminates shit. You know what I'm saying? My mom is old. She's not like that. But a dude named Louis, Sicilian, he was real plugged in, you know what I'm saying? So he got us tickets. And yeah, I was 5 years old, bro. And I was at Dodger Stadium. And I have that pennant somewhere where it says, you know, Dodgers, Yankees, 1970. I never forget that shit. That shit was crazy. That was my first time at Dodger Stadium. But your Houston Astros, they ain't banging on no trash cans this year, dog. What's good, man?
Man, you know. Seems like it's like they needed them trash cans, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, seriously, bro. Think about it. And Jimmy, don't play with me, bro.
Bro.
You know the motherfuckers was cheating, right?
I plead the fifth, but bro, what's that? What's that music? You hear that?
Oh, you don't know what that is?
Bro, what is that?
You don't know what that is?
That sound like, don't that sound like Willie Hutch?
Ladies and gentlemen, Coda's Ice premiere, debuting. It has been, last time I think I did a Willie Hutch, had to been motherfucking Travis Scott. And I had to ether that bum. And I'm going to say this right motherfucking now, Coda's Ice, Jimmy Boy, Dust Brothers. Jimmy, this is your first time witnessing a Willie Hutch. There is a podcast called the Sneak Diss Podcast that came for the God. And your boy been Ben Humble for a couple years now. Maybe a few years I've been humble. Jimmy, you ever heard of anything called a Sneak Diss Podcast before?
Nah, I ain't never heard of that.
Okay. Well, I never heard of these motherfuckers either.
See what this is about.
And they had to come at me. And they had to come at me a little sideways, a little spicy, out of nowhere. They tried to do a little sneak diss, again, like they little punk-ass, lame-ass podcast.
What they okay? talking about, bro?
So, Miles, turn the Willie Hutch up just a little bit more. Okay, listen here. I don't even know your motherfucking name. I just know Sneak Diss Podcast. You have some major audacity. Bro, you weigh 600 pounds, dog. You 550 at least. Bro, you are a motherfucking amateur sneakerhead. You are not about nothing OG at all whatsoever. You said you collected sneakers in the 80s? Bro, what the fuck are you talking about, dog? You sit at home and look in the mirror and get depressed, bro. There's no way you got any fresh kicks at your size, bro. Period.
Dude had some Air Max, they became Air Flats right away.
Dog, as soon as he put some Air Maxes on.
How did y'all choose the name Sneak This? Bro, you so big, bro, you can't sneak nothing, bro. You can't even sneak a bag of popcorn in nowhere. You a tub of lard. You made me look skinny, bro. You made me look like a bad bitch. What the fuck? Oh, hell on, no. Bro. I know y'all ain't trying to come at this, bro. Go ahead, Ben. Hold me back, bro. Hold me back, please.
Hold on. I've been in the game legit since the motherfucking Sky Force One, a.k.a. the Air Force One for kids. Okay, George Gervin. All right, Dr. Duncanstein. Let's go back to 81. Let's go back. How old were you in 81? Were you born yet?
I wasn't born,
you probably
bro.
Weren't. What was your OG Nike Park name? That was 1999. Please tell me. Was you on the internet then? Did you even have internet? Did you have dial-up? What did you have? Show me a Nike Talk screen name. But let's go back a little bit again. Jimmy says something real. Actually, it makes a lot of sense. You cannot put on just Air Max. You couldn't put on anything with Air. You put any Nike shoe with air in it, and them motherfuckers is going flat. They losing everything. All the air coming out that bitch. How the fuck are you? You are for real top 10 goofies? Bro, you are the goofiest of all goofies, bro. Nothing you've ever done has pushed anything in the sneaker culture forward. You've never been in the game in your life. You never sat on the side. Bro, there's no fucking way. Homie, you're watching this from that couch, bro. Look at that couch, Jimmy.
Bro,
look at that couch, dog.
You said they was talking shit on Twitter.
Yeah, just talking shit on Twitter, bro.
Bro, how was he able to type anything on Twitter? My hands is too big for Twitter. That boy hands got to be three times the size of mine, bro. Like, I'm confused right now. You know what I'm saying, like, bro?
Dog. Dude, it must be the little top 10.
It must be the little guy. It must be the skinnier guy that's doing all that, because I know that big boy ain't doing nothing but sitting there eating some food.
Skinny dude is corny too. Get him the fuck out of here. Dude said top 10 dweeb. Bro, listen, you got that dude on your team, instant L. Immediately losing. Okay? Really, bro? And I was gonna say, this ain't even David and Goliath. This was more like a whale versus a tic-tac until I seen the motherfucker size. So let's get into some real shit, okay? So this is a whale versus a megalodon, okay? But, you know, people will be like, hey, man, why are you even going at these dudes, man? They ain't nobody. They just out there doing shit. It's like, you have to be a real fucking loser, first of all, to create a cop podcast just to diss people you don't like, whatever else. And then I see you get some people. You had Skate the Great, people I know, whatever, and this and that. You ain't got nobody with no motion, motherfucker. I've had... You know what I'm saying? Like, dog, I got Kanye asking me for sneaker advice. I got Frank Cooker playing at my golf tournaments. I have dudes, OGs. Mark Parker flew me on a Nike jet. Like, bro, what the fuck is you talking about? You sound corny as shit. They're like, why are you wasting your energy on them? But, Jimmy, you ever had a mosquito bite you?
Because we got time today.
Exactly. We got time today, bro. And I ain't even got a watch on today, dog. I ain't got a watch on. Look, you ever had a mosquito bite you? Mosquito just nothing, right? Right? Mm-hmm. Annoying as shit. How much effort does it kill to offer? How much effort does it take to kill a mosquito?
You just gotta push on it.
Not much at all.
But sometimes you just want to smack that motherfucker.
Yeah, dog. You just have to squeeze it. You know what I'm saying? But the thing is, there's millions of more of them to come, right? But right now is time to put the Sneak Dibs podcast on the Summer Jam screen. Okay, you weren't even there, dork or dorks, whatever the dudes' names are. Let's call Fat Boy. And the black dude. I don't even know who the fucking dude's name is, okay?
Well, call him Fat Boy Slim.
Okay. Fat Boy and Slim. Yeah. How about that? You want to do that? Okay. So, I guess we go pull out the raid, the bug spray, some fire, all that shit. But look, you guys are 100% goofy. This is a fact. It's not up for debate at all whatsoever. Listen, I'm going to ask you one thing right now, Jimmy. Have you ever heard of anything fly... In your life, coming out of Phoenix, Arizona, have you ever?
Some fly ladies, you know what I'm saying? That's about it.
Okay, listen, man. Never ever in the history of the game, since day one, has there ever been any style, any fashion, any sneaker culture derived in Phoenix. Y'all have no motion. Zero motion, period. And then again, back, let me ask you a question. How old were you in 1985 when the Air Jordan 1 came out? Because you said you've been OG collecting since the 80s. Bro, you are... Dog, I don't know how much longer you're going to live. That's for goddamn sure, bro. Because,
bro, he got to be old to get that big. You know, it takes some time to get that big, bro. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I was like,
that's not even amazing about Phoenix, Arizona, though. Like, look, man, let's just be real. Look, man, y'all haters, I can tell why you hate. You sit on the couch all day. Look, man, you heard of 600 Pound Life, the TV show. It's in Houston. I know Dr. Down. I could plug you in, get you a little weight loss program going on, get you a little bypass before you bypass. And maybe you could really see yourself, put yourself some Air Maxes on, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, what size shoes?
Hold on. Stop.
You know what I'm saying?
Stop, bro. This dude, for sure, this dude is a 14 wide. And I'm talking about extra wide. Bro, could you imagine? That motherfucker got two pairs of shoes and stitch them together.
And I can say this because I'm fat. I was even fatter. All right? But you look like a type of dude, you tie your shoelaces, your knots be on the side of the shoe, not even in the center. Come on, baby boy. Come on, baby boy. Don't come barking up the wrong tree, because over here, man.
Nah, dog.
Come on, a pop called Sneak Diss.
Hey.
Y'all look like some Sneak Disses. This come
motherfucker,
on, man.
Hey, this motherfucker.
On Twitter?
This motherfucker blood type is, hey, bro, his blood type is Ben and Jerry's, dog, first of all.
Bro, if he gained 5 more pounds, he ain't get group insurance.
If I seen him in the middle of the street and try to drive around him, I'd run out of gas, bro. But let me say something real quick. Let's say you in your late 30s, early 40s, maybe. So let's just go with the Jordan 4. Okay, maybe the Jordan 3. How old was that? You was maybe 8, 9? You wasn't buying no motherfucking kicks at 8 or 9, bro. Fuck out of here, dog. You a motherfucking cornball, bro. What was you... You know, now I think about it, he might have been 8 or 9 years old, maybe slanging some Lunchables, but he probably was his best customer. That motherfucker was eating all them bitches. You know what I'm saying? And the crazy part is, let me look at this show real quick.
Get him, hold Ben.
On. That motherfucker called
Get
me
him.
A top... See, 8 years, they've been doing the Sneak Diss podcast for 8 years, bro. Can you imagine 8 years? They have 300 reviews. In 8 years, they got 300 reviews, bro. 350 episodes in 8 years, bro. I know you guys got a day job, or you may be on disability or some shit. Like, where you work out, bro?
Foot Locker.
Because I know this can't be your main shit. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, Sneak Diss podcast? Like, bro, come on. Man, let me guess. Let me guess. We do it for the love. We do it for the sneaker love. You guys are ruining the culture. Shut the fuck up, bro. You're a fucking clown, bro. You do it for your 217 listeners. Bro, I was going to talk about, I didn't see the dude, so I had some notes. I didn't see dude till you showed me, dude. Like, bro, both you motherfuckers probably never played varsity anything in your entire life, bro. Y'all are JV. You guys are junior varsity. Every single thing you've done in your life since day one is JV. You never, not even on, you, dog, you're not even professional podcasters. Y'all 100% goofy. Like, again, man, dog, bro, this is crazy, dog. I'm trying to look through here, okay? They don't have no motion at all. Like, dog, you realize I've been asked to do every single, by the way, Miles, just stop the music. Stop the Willie Hutch music, bro. It's too much, man.
Mm-hmm.
I have been asked to do every single sneaker. I was one of the first episodes of Sneaker Shopping, right? I've been asked to do every fucking single relevant sneaker podcast has asked me to be on their fucking show. And I'm sorry for the strays that are being caught right now, but I'm not Joe LaPuma. I'm not some corporate dude who's going to be on some funny shit and try to be cool. Fuck all that bullshit. I'm not Ronnie Feig or any of these other dudes that get along. I say some shit to people, try to be cool. I know what's going to catch, you know what I'm saying? Vibes, going to catch views. But I don't spit cap. I really was there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I did a favor for the owner of Got Soul, and the shit went viral all over all the social media platforms just to do homies, you know, show us homies some love. You know, they dropped me some kicks, got my kids some kicks, dropped me a little bread, you know what I mean? But you're mad at that because I'm sitting here telling stories because you ain't got no stories to tell. You just want to sit here and judge. Again, not even from the sidelines, not even from the stands, because your ass is way too big to sit on. Hey, you'll break a motherfucking bench. You'll break some pavilion seats. Okay, you sitting on your couch watching hating. It's crazy, bro. And you're mad because I'm still relatable. Like, I'm still more relevant than ever. Nobody knows you, bro. Nobody has ever heard of you. And that's the part that hurts your head. Real talk, right? Like, I never needed a big corporation to back me. And it's just like, dog, y'all the goofy motherfuckers used to wait in line, bro. And then you probably couldn't wait in line because you probably, your blood sugar got low and you had to go eat some motherfucking Waffle House or some shit.
He was probably at a store one day and was about to buy the last pair of shoes that were about to come out, and you came up and grabbed them, bro, and he mad at you for that, or something, bro.
Yeah, yeah. Nah, dog. I'm just, bro, listen, dog. Let's just break the facts down. I became a millionaire off of selling my Nike, my sneaker collection. Okay, that is a fact. That is certified. That is verified, right? And that was in 2004, right? I didn't want to wear Nikes, didn't wear Nikes for 8 motherfucking years. They reached out to me, and Ye had reached out to me talking about, this is a fucking real story. These are facts, okay? And I only sold my shit because Nike hated on me when we was doing my Terminator shoe. My boy, Mr. Cartoon, just got his Air Force One, and I was like, man, fuck these dudes. And this was Dar Levon, Drew Greer, all them. I was like, man, fuck everyone at Nike. I don't give a fuck what this, that is all some cornball shit, the Blue House. Yeah, some experiences. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. If you're a real OG sneakerhead, you remember this shit. So if you fucking been in the game that long, there's no motherfucking way you didn't know that I created the term stockroom picks, and that shit was banned on Nike Talk because motherfuckers was out here before Benjamin Kicks or any of these little goofy motherfuckers is out here, all these little BGs. You was not no OG, bro. Dog, I'm old, bro. I've been in this game. I fed a lot of people in this game, too. You know what I mean? That BB logo means something to people. But anyways, you got anything to say before we, because I just, look, hey, all they gonna do is hate from the little apartment.
Yeah, moral of the story, man, hating ain't never gonna get you nowhere, and especially sneak dissing. You know what I mean? Like, y'all just got y'all 15 minutes of fame, so we hope that y'all do something with this and really capitalize and get y'all some money so y'all can stop hating, man.
Bro, what kind of car you think dude drive, bro?
He can't drive. He too big, bro. He got to be in the back of the minivan type thing. He probably can't fit in the driver's seat of a car. Ain't no way. I'm sorry. Just on some real shit.
Yeah, dog.
Bro, you got to get checked, bro. No, bypass surgery. They're affordable, yeah, now. Dog. And like I said, 600-pound life. They'll do it for free, and they'll shine light into your life. So, you know, you can get some action going on. Y'all can really promote the brand and everything y'all got, because it come two and two, you know, hating and being depressed and all that. That's what it really is, man.
Yeah, dog. Yeah. Now, you know what? Let's bring up some good news. Well, not good news necessarily.
Yeah.
Jonas' birthday just passed. My best friend, my best man, my best motherfucking dog for life ever. Jimmy, you ever meet Jonas before?
No, I never met him.
You never met Jimmy back in the day when I was with him all the time? You never met him? I mean, Jonas, you never met him?
Yeah, no, I never met him in person, no.
You know Jonas was adopted, right, by an Italian family?
Mm-hmm. I remember.
Do you know what he was? His best friend. Yeah,
Vietnamese. I remember you told me,
Vietnamese,
we were gonna meet. You know what I mean? During that time, remember I was dealing with that case, so I was going back and forth. He was a lot, so I ain't really was able to catch up, man.
He knew you. I know. Not you represent. You rep the LRG back in the day. You know, and Bun B was. By the way, shout out to Bun B. Much love, H Town legend.
Yes, sir.
But yeah, Jonas's 47th birthday was on Wednesday, and I just want to say happy birthday, Jonas. I love you. 47 birthday, is significant, Jonas. Because the company was based, the entire corporation and company of LRG was based on 1947, his mom's birthday. And by the way, shout out to Jersey Joe Bavacqua, my old accountant. That's Jonas's dad. So 47 was always a big thing, like 47 till infinity. You know, if you see the stuff, it would say 47 research, it would say 1947, all that stuff and everything. That was basically, so 47 was always a very big number in his life. So happy birthday, Jonas. I miss you. I know you've seen the post, the major post. I don't think I would be doing what I do today if it wasn't for your motivation every day that I get up and think about you. And Aiden has to be fucking 19, 20 years old by now. I don't even know. And I apologize for not keeping in touch with other people. You know, it got ugly, bro. When you would pass, man. They tried to pass me off as the bad guy. And then it took like 4 years for people. Kevion knew what the deal was. And by the way, we're going to get Kevion on the show. Kevion, if you're listening, bro, we're going to get you on the show soon. But about 4 years later, a lot of people realized I wasn't the bad guy. And I was like, all right, cool. I laid in the cut, kept my head down, you know. But I just got to give a big, big, big happy birthday to my best friend, Jonas Bavacqua, man. Best friend,
fucking
my dog for life. I love you, bro.
Speaking of birthdays, dog, I want to just wish my son, Jimmy Jr., a happy birthday, man. His birthday was on Monday. Man, you know what I'm saying? His 11th birthday.
JJ. And,
man.
What'd he get? What'd you get him for his birthday? You.
Bro, I just got him a bunch of Robux and money in his account, man. That's all he really cared about. We threw a little party, nothing crazy.
Hey, keep it up. How many Robux you give him? Like 25,000 Robux, 50,000 Robux?
I gave him 2,000 cash. He said it. Totals out to, I forgot what he told me the calculation was at. I think it was like 100, right?
That's gonna be 1,000 Robux is 100,000. So 2,000, so 200,000 Robux.
Yeah.
It's a lot of Robux, fam. That's a
and
lot.
And he ain't never
dog.
Had
he
that much,
dominance
bro.
With
he
that.
Was he was super
nah,
lit,
dog.
So.
When I get, yeah, that's crazy. You know, one of my cousins gave London 100,000 Robux. That shit was crazy. Mm-hmm. Anyways, going back, talking about missing people. It's on my notes, dog. I'm going to keep it a buck with you, bro. I miss the old Jimmy boy, bro. The Jimmy boy when we see somebody on the street. I'll be like, yo, man, let's go back and smack this motherfucker. And you got the fucking, you got the Draco ready to go. And we gonna ride on him. And now you like, yo, bro, listen, man, nah, dog, just chill, bro. Just keep your, you got too much positive energy. You like a teddy bear now, bro. You wanna cuddle with girls, bro. You wanna wait, never have a one-night stand.
I always like, cuddle. What you talking about? You know what I'm saying?
Dog, I just don't like this soft.
I fight with, that's why I call myself Jimmy the Gent now, you know, like, I feel like I fight with Jimmy Boy every day, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, it's a constant struggle. And, you know, people would never know who they'll get until they approach me. And if y'all really know who Jimmy the Gent is too, y'all should Google Jimmy the Gent and find out why I was named Jimmy the Gent.
Well, first of all, bro, I just remember back in the day that the cocky Jimmy pushing up in a Bentley to Drake's first concert in Houston and be like, don't worry about me, going to the club, buying shit here and there, whatever. And it's like, listen, guys, I'm not trying to say this to diss anybody, but like, Jimmy will ball out and I'll come up somewhere and he'll just be riding with me. He'd be cool. And it was almost like a Batman and Robin thing. I'm not dissing Jimmy. He was just like, you know, my partner, he rode, didn't say shit, right?
Never. Yeah,
and I see Jimmy go out and I see Jimmy out with his crew and this motherfucker got an entourage. He running the show. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Jimmy, what's up, bro? Why you act all weird around me, bro? This and that, you know, being chill here and there, like, you know, and like, I'll pay for shit here and there. Like now, Jimmy won't let me pay for nothing. We go to Matsuhisa and this motherfucker ordered enough uni for the Goonies, right? Like he really, how much uni did we order that time, bro?
Bro, they ran
like
out.
Like 20 orders? I'm being serious, bro.
Yeah, they ran out, man. I was kind of upset. We ordered about like 20, 25
they had
pieces.
20 orders, bro. That's 40 pieces.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dog, that's fucking, they had to go back to Santa Barbara to go get the uni. Okay, that's Matsuhisa. Anyways, no, just Jimmy, man. I just miss the old Jimmy that once in a while I fly off the handle, want to pull out the toaster.
Bro, you
and
know.
Be out there like, what'd you say? Like, you just be too nice, bro. I don't know, man.
We gonna do what to do, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's all it is, man. And speaking of all that, it's never that. You know, it's always about playing the position. You always been the big bro. You know what I mean? I do what I do, but when I'm with you, I always play my position, man. I play the back until I need to play the front. You know what I'm saying? And that's the thing a lot of y'all motherfuckers out here in this world don't understand is that people talk about stay down to the come up. Now, you're supposed to be down even when y'all come up. You play your position. You become your own boss, but you don't become the boss of your boss, or you don't become the big brother of your big brother. You know what I'm saying? So y'all, that's where y'all got shit fucked up. Y'all don't understand is that y'all trying to take a person place. Don't take a person place. Build your own motherfucking place, bro. You know what I'm saying? So y'all got to understand that. Learn the real rules. Learn what the game is really about, man. What the codes is really about, man. That's what loyalty and that's what real shit is about. That's how my name stretched this far. Ben name going to stretch this far and it's going to keep stretching. Because we all know to play our position and keep doing what we do. You know what I'm saying? You ain't seen Ben back in the day with Dre trying to be Dre. Ben was Ben. That's why that BB means something now. It wouldn't have meant something if he was trying to be Dre. Come on, bro.
You know, 19 years, bro. I'm running with this cat, Jimmy. 19 years, right? It's a long time. And about 4 years ago, no shit. That was 5 years ago. We was walking through Complex Con in Long Beach. And I was there with Murakami, Cuddy, J Balvin. We was running around doing all that shit. Me and J Balvin exchanged some words and Jimmy walked over to me. And Bait had just dropped that gold bear brick, the all gold in the gold box. And I was like, yo, this is the owner of Bait. This is my boy Jimmy. Can you get him one? Whatever. We start talking. Every single time I did something, Jimmy never tried to infiltrate, never tried to hate, never tried to do anything. He made his own lane, tried to figure out a way to go get something here and there. And he could ask me. And if he did, I'd help him. No problem. Sometimes he just did his own thing. And the crazy part, reason why I'm bringing this story up is some dude walked up to me. I don't know if you remember this, Jimmy. Some dude was like, hey, bro, I want to get a chain, dog. And I was like, okay. I was like, what you working? What you trying to get? He goes, I got like probably like 35 bands. And I was like, yeah, that ain't going to work with me, bro. And I was like, but you know what though, dog? My man right here, this is my guy, and he has top quality work, and he got you. And right then and there, Jimmy could have been like, you know what, man, fuck Ben, man. He's trying to look at me like I'm some secondhand jeweler, I'm some other whatever. He didn't take it like that. That's not the energy I got. He was like, yeah, I got you. And the motherfuckers exchanged number. They did business. And I would shoot a lot of shit that way. And I know my cousin would probably look at me, watch this podcast now, and be like, Ben, why the fuck we got four other employees that could use? Nah, dog, because this is my brother, and he out here, and I'm going to make sure he cool too. So you remember I passed you that. That was one of many, but I'm saying, you remember that day or no?
No, I remember that day. Like, you know, I remember everything, bro. And that's the thing, you know what I'm saying? And that's just what that is, you know what I mean? Like, when you play your part, man, you're gonna get what you put in life, man. This grind, that's what it's about, man. And y'all don't get that, you know what I'm saying? That's just all it come down to, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's all about really who you are as a character, as a person, bro. Talking about that, bro, you even remember when that whole World Star Chain shit too, you know what I'm saying? When that shit happened, you know what I mean? And how I was able, somebody hit me up, gave that to me, gave it to you. You see how things work, man? Everything is in full circle, man. Y'all gotta know that.
I forgot about that, bro.
Full circle, man.
By the way, I forgot
man.
About that, dog.
You know what I mean?
I forgot Straight about up. That, bro. That shit is crazy, bro. And by the way, rest in peace, Leo Donat, a.k.a. Q World Star. His
yes,
birthday's
sir,
actually
man.
Coming up in less than 2 weeks, man. Funny thing mm-hmm. is, Lee was born on the same day as my dad, November 2nd, man. I miss you, Lee. Miss you, Q.
But going hey, back talking to about... Talking about like popping off though, you know what I mean? Just talking about popping off, man, and me not, you know, going back to that no more. I'm glad that I'm not, you know what I mean? Because as you can see, you know, Tesla coming out with these robots, these Optimuses, and they can do all that for us now, bro.
Bro, have you seen what these motherfucking robots is doing, bro?
Bro, I don't care. All I know is they get with me, I'm going to show them how it go. And they're going to hit that road and they're going to do what I know. And we're going to get that gold.
Hey, it's going to be some... Hold on, bro. I'm going to show you. This is going to be... Hold on. I'm
Everybody keeps talking about, right like, now, you don't remember iRobot? Yeah, I remember iRobot. But guess what? In iRobot, that's what y'all get for trying to be friendly with these fucking robots, bro. They're robots, bro. Treat them like you need to treat
hold
them.
On,
you know
bro.
What I'm saying?
Hold on, bro. Can you see this? Can you see that right there?
Sure, go down. Point down. Point down some
you
more.
You see that?
Yeah.
You see that? You see that?
Yep.
That's the face that the Optimus robot is gonna make when I ask her to give me roadhead when I'm driving a motherfucking Tesla. Oh yeah, I need to get a little shit, bro. Why you bullshit?
You
no,
imagine?
Seriously, dog. Robots is.
Can you just imagine,
bro, taking
though, bro,
over McDonald's?
In this world, like, bro? You see, they just opened supposedly a hospital in China, bro, and there's 14 doctors that are AI robots, bro.
Nah, stop playing, bro.
I just read that earlier today. Yes, bro. It's a
yeah,
hospital
nah, dog,
in China.
I'm not having no doctor. I ain't had no AI robot operate on me. You tripping, bro.
But
hey,
just
listen,
imagine,
dog. Someone
bro.
Said they had a cure for gout. They said they had a cure for gout and it was an AI robot. Would you go and do it?
It depends on what the procedure is. If it's not life-threatening, I'd give it a try. You know what I'm saying? After seeing a couple people do it.
Man, you tripping,
I won't
bro.
Be the first.
You tripping, bro.
But could you just imagine, bro?
I'll tell you what you...
People walking around, right? And then they bump into each other and they're like, what's up then, fool? And then the robots just start fighting each other for them.
Dog, could you imagine? Hey, could you imagine Bloods and Crip, robot Crips, robot
Oh
Bloods?
My God, bro. With the RoboCop gun coming out the thigh?
How about, hold the fuck up. What about robot Kartel, robot drug dealers?
I'm telling
I'm
you, bro.
I'm being serious,
about
to bro.
Get no, I know. That's what I'm saying. It's about to get crazy, bro.
But hold on, Jimmy, I got to interrupt
how
you, bro.
You
we got to go back
robot.
To some shit.
Mm-hmm.
No idea. I unplugged them motherfuckers. Hey, I got this shit. I've been getting these DMs, bro, about last week's episode, fam questions. Mm-hmm. And the one I got the most was about you bullshitting about not wanting to fuck a tranny, bro. And I'm going to tell you something funny. I'm going to tell you something real funny about this shit, okay? Listen, hold on. Stop, dog. Me and my girl had a... And you already know. You know she loves you to death. We had this conversation, right? And you was like, listen, dog. I had my boy. was He had his manhood taken in prison. He went crazy. He lost his mind. All this other shit. Jimmy. What you not understanding is, this is $5, $10 million that you are not getting raped. You are not, you are allowing somebody to stick their little ding-a-ling in your booty hole for a little bit for $5, $10 million.
See,
this
bro,
ain't no mental illness shit. Where you in jail, you getting raped is a different story. This is that you talking about allowing a dude. You are capping. Even my girl was like, nah.
Bro.
I'm letting him do it, man, bro. You tripping.
You gotta understand something, right? It's not about you see, you're getting into all this detail now talking about a dude with a little wee-wee do. It don't matter, bro. It's not about being raped or nothing. It's about a belief that I believe in and like a code that I've had. And I'm not gonna break that code for no amount of money, bro. Like I bro, I'm sorry. And y'all can say, think whatever, do whatever, bro. Like that, you know, like I said, if it's me fucking somebody. Now, you know, that's a different story, but as far as some going,
okay, that, okay. For 500 bands, would you fuck a beautiful tranny with some beautiful tits in the ass? Would you fuck?
For 500 bands. She still got her
dick. Nobody, nah. Nobody gonna know about it but you and her.
Then I guess we'll find out if I'm ever 500 bands richer.
You know, you seen the memes, right? Them old, them funny ass TikToks where a dude be like, yo, man, it's a sick motherfucking people out here, bro.
You know what you need to tell your girl, you know, our last name, we hold with pride. She's wrong for even thinking I would even do something like that with our last name. Darn it. You better tell her. I'm kind of upset with her right now to even think that. She should have been standing up there like, he's right. Bro. I believe it, babe.
Bro. She agree on you a damn near everything. I never win a conference. Yo, because y'all got that Viet shit, she'd be like, yo, fuck that. You need to be more like Jimmy to be like this, da-da-da-da. But that one, she's like, yo, you tripping. You never seen the memes where them, like, them old, like, hick white boy dudes be sitting in a truck, be like, man, some sick fucking people out here, man. This fucking dude just said he'll suck my dick for a fucking case of fucking Heinekens. And I was like, you a fucking sick motherfucker. Fuck is wrong with you? And then they start drinking a Heineken. You ain't seen that shit before?
Yeah.
Yeah, this shit funny as fuck. All right, hey, one last topic. Well, kind of one last talk before we wrap it up. I just tried to get out here and get some shit. We got some shit coming. Jimmy coming into town this weekend. We go get some shit going. I got a couple people lined up. We'll see what happens. But wanted to just kind of just, we gave you an hour and a half last week. This week we go give you, 35, 40 minutes, whatever this show is at right now. Jimmy, have you ever seen this podcast? It's an Asian podcast. They blew up. It's called Under the Influence Podcast. It's like three dudes and one Asian girl. Sometimes two Asian girls. And one of the dudes is Viet. Another dude's like Filipino. I think one dude might be Korean. You never seen that Under the Influence podcast? You never seen them before?
I might have seen clips, but no, I've never actually in the
really, really head, no. Popular in the space, doc. I'm going to keep it a buck, bro. They started following me. They asked me to be on a show. They're sponsored by some seltzer brand or some other shit. They're doing really well, dog. They really, you know, they had a lot of followers.
So shout out to them.
They got motion. They're doing the thing. No. Hold that salute back first for 1 second, bro.
Okay.
So, dog, they be saying some wild shit. They say some wild shit. And I was like, what the fuck is they trending for? Bruh, of all people, dog, the Korean girl. And she thinks she bad. Dog. You know what a real, like a legit six is? An LA six? LA 6, but like maybe a Houston 7.5. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about? Asian girl, right? Think about a girl that's a 6 that really thinks she the shit, got a couple hundred thousand followers. You know, mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about? I'm painting the picture for you. You feel me? Like the attitude, what they think, you know, this and that. The attitude, what they got. You know, mm-hmm. And think about a Korean girl too, especially like a, you know, one of them fucking, you know, thick skull Korean girls, right? And she looked, again,
strong. Her face a little strong.
You can accentuate everything. Do the little fillers, the fucking filters. Get your hair cool. Get a couple little things here and there, and think you cool. You know whatever. Yeah. I didn't have nothing bad to say. I just kept my mouth shut until she got on a show. I guess 5 days ago or something, and I just caught the clip, bro. This chick went on the show in front of everyone on the show and said, "Hey, you want to know why black women have bigger pussies than the average, than all races? Because, you know, black men got big dicks. So in general, when black men, you know, they're having sex with black women, they stretch their pussies out. That's why all their vaginas are wider than other ones. And you see Asian girls, they're tighter." Bro, she said that this motherfucker's recorded this with a conscious mind, and it wasn't live. They recorded, probably edited it like we do, and then put it out. And they actually put that shit on the universe and thought it was going to be like, okay. Like, bro, the community, dog, Asians, blacks, Latinas, you name it, people are enraged about it. Like, not as bad as the fucking the Maria Nguyen and that other the little 23 year old white boy from Biloxi, but it's bad, bro. Like, they getting canceled. They whole fucking all their comments is fucked up. They getting ratioed left and right. But
you know, that's the thing, bro. Like, I feel like you know everything is not for everybody. You know what I'm saying? And that's what the world now is like. Social media and all these things has everybody thinking that everything is for everybody. People start feeling themselves and they start saying things that they don't mean, bro. That's what I'm trying to say. It's just like,
and now people, the thing is,
like,
no, I could see in her mind where she thought that might have been okay, and she thought she was maybe complimenting, but no, she don't realize how disgusting that was, because Asian women are like some of the most fetishized women that walk the earth. They got to deal with this bullshit. You never seen like Asian women that it's always like these like be like white dudes that fetishize them on some geisha shit.
Nah, for sure, and be on for that sure. Shit. Like, you what seen I'm anybody? Just saying, bro, like,
and it's like, you got to worry about Vanna.
Educated woman, you know what I'm saying? And for you to be in that position where you have people listening, or you're influencing and everything, you have to be more educated in that to say something that naive and ignorant. You know what I'm saying? It's just this is just be real stupid, about that, bro. Like. You know what I mean? Like, how old is this girl? You know what I mean? She not educated enough, and she don't deserve to be in that position.
I say she's, you know what I'm saying? I think she's early 30s, maybe. She young. She's stupid. Maybe late 20s.
Yeah, like,
just dumb.
She definitely was.
But I got a question
herself.
For you. Serious question.
Yeah.
Jimmy, in all your lifetime, have you ever had sex with a black woman?
Yes, I have.
Okay. Did the pussy feel different? Did it feel like it was wider or some other shit? I'm being asked. I'm being honest, bro.
Nah, bro. You know what I mean? Like, no.
I've had sex with a lot of black women, bro.
You know what I mean? Like, I didn't feel or see anything different.
I mean, different girls have different. I'm gonna keep it.
It ain't about the race. It ain't about the race.
Yeah, I've been with Asian women, and it felt like a hot dog was going down the hallway. You feel me? Mm-hmm. Like, I've been with all kinds of shit, right?
Yeah.
And
there's some girls
regardless,
that be loose as a goose. You know what I mean? Like, extra lip action, everything. Some girls, they pussies like a little like back more. Some are deeper, some short. It ain't about race, bro. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, I don't know if she was trying to be funny or whatever, but you know, and
you got me thinking about Arby's right now. And I like Arby's, but goddamn, you see that shit? I got a headache thinking about it, bro. Anyways, point of the story is you will not see Ben Baller or Jimmy Boy on Under the Influence podcast. It's a lot of podcasts that ask me to get on the show, bro.
And yeah, man.
I've been doing some shit here and there, but you know what, dog? Pretty soon, we gonna do a podcast tour, bro. We gonna do $1 million worth of game, probably. I know Wallow and them follow me. But I wanna
shout
do it with
to
you.
Wallow, man. Shout
I don't wanna just do it with me.
Yep.
To Gilly.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Gilly,
right.
Man.
Anyways, to end this, bro, I wanna end this real quick.
Shout
gotta
out
get
to my
going.
Philly people, man. My
Johns
out there. Y'all know y'all be Johning, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Philly.
Jimmy.
Yeah.
Does Jimmy or Jackson, do any of them play sports at school or no?
Well, Jimmy was playing sports. He was playing, Jackson plays soccer. Jimmy, you know, we just started playing golf, you know what I mean? So at school, he's not doing no sports no more. We're focusing on
golf. But have they done any team competitions or a game actually that you went to, like they playing, and, you know, with referees and an audience and all that shit or no, with crowd?
No, not yet, you know what I mean?
All right, so check it out, dog. Ryder just started football.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when I think about when I played football for real, I think I started right around 11. I didn't get serious till about 12. Since we started playing tackle, right? Pop Warner, my bad. Started playing Pop Warner around 12, La Siena Park. And you know, we using pads hitting. This is flag football. It's for the school. It really matters. They did some scrimmages, but now they playing, you know, Ryder's team in school is small, but they play against all the schools in the district, whatever. And, you know, Ryder's second team, but he plays special teams. He's second team defensive end and second team offensive left tackle, right?
Damn,
and, you know, Ryder don't know much about football. And I feel bad because, you know, think about it, Jimmy. I played football in college, bro. How many motherfuckers get to go play college on a scholarship, right? D1. Yeah. And, you know, I think about it. It's like, damn. So I started showing up to the practices, started talking to the coaches, started coming there and giving them a lot of insight, right? The coach is good. He's real tough. He's hard as nails. He ain't on some pussy shit. He'll be screaming at them, yelling at them, and I like it. Get some discipline. Ryder's starting to lose a little weight. So they had their first game last week and they won. And then they had a back-to-back game. They had a game on Saturday, right? And they won. And it was dope because it was a big school.
That's
and this school had cheerleaders and everything. We didn't have that school. And then Ryder got cleats. I'm happy. And in that first game, bro, Ryder was coming off a block. And this big-ass kid on the other team knocked Ryder the fuck over. I mean, I saw him fall. Oh, I got goosebumps right now on my arms. You can see. knocked Ryder over, fell down and flipped over. And I was like, damn. And Ryder was so nervous and so, he had so much adrenaline going in. You know, he's never been involved in a game before. He's like totally different. You know, London and Kai don't know what that's like. And he's out there. He's like, and he got up, he smiled. I was like, Ryder, I was like, shake it off. It's all good. It's all, shake it off, shake it off. You know, and the other kids were getting fucked up here and there. And the parents were like, yo, don't let them push you around. And I'm saying, Ryder, you are stronger than him. Fuck that kid. Fuck that. I'm screaming on the sideline and everything. That shit kind of, my heart kind of stopped when I seen him get knocked down. You feel me? But that's part of the game, right? Bro. He got up.
It's a part
wasn't
of the
even
game.
Tripping. Yeah, he wasn't even
I'm
tripping.
I'm proud of him, man. For and real. Good job, Ryder.
I was proud of him, dog. And then the next day, we lost our two-star players because they had a baseball game today. And then we got our ass whipped by a team that was straight up cheating. The refs was on their shit. They tried to end the game at the end of the third quarter. I was like, what the fuck is you talking about? There's 17 seconds left. Motherfucker, we ain't even switched sides yet. We switch sides every quarter. Did you realize that? You have to go into the fourth quarter. We still got some game. And then these kids had like their flags were tied. They were guarding their flag. They was doing some real cheap shit here and there. And so anyways, I understand now when you see some of these parents that got to step outside and really get away because they get too violent and they get too crazy. And I get involved like that because I played ball and I just want my son to, you know, be a starter eventually and get all that. And I sat on the bench a lot. I didn't start flourishing until my sophomore, junior year in high school. You know what I'm saying? I sat on the bench a lot. Then even in college, I sat the bench for a long time until I started really coming in. And it's a lot of work and it's like something. But anyways, Ryder, I'm proud of you. I know you do watch the show here and there. We know you shouldn't because I use a bad language. But yeah, so Ryder's team is officially 1-1 right now. We got a game this Saturday.
That's what's up. Good luck to
shit.
Ryder, man.
You get you in Saturday. It, you get in tomorrow. What time you get in?
I actually get in Thursday. So I'm in. I'm there.
Okay, shit, dog. You might have to come to the game, bro.
Yeah, let me know, bro.
You might have to come to the game on Saturday, bro. Hey, you're going to pull up on Saturday, dog. We're going to fight.
Yep.
We're going to fight the motherfucking dads out there. But yeah. Is there anything else you want to talk about before we wrap up, man?
That Jimmy boy going to come out. Don't worry. When it comes time. Nah, not really too much, man. But speaking on what you're saying, I know what it feels like. Cause you know, Vanna was playing and I'll never forget the one time she got elbowed in the face, bro, on a basketball game. And my heart stopped, bro. And I was with like three of her uncles. So we jumped up at first, like we were about to run out there. And I stopped all of us. I was like, hold on real quick. Just let her do what she needed to do. And I'm getting goosebumps thinking about it, talking about it. Like she got up, bro, shook it off, wiped her face. She had some blood. But went back in there and dogged them out and won the game, bro. You know what I mean? And that's the best thing we could teach our children, man, is team, you know, like sportsmanship, man. And that's the beautiful part of it all, man. That's the beautiful part of it all.
That's it, dog. Well, I'll say this, guys. Thank you for listening to today's episode. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, whether you listen on Apple, Spotify, Amazon, Google Play, wherever you listen to. You watch it on YouTube. I'm going to say this one last time. 58% of y'all are watching without subscribing. Just hit the subscribe button. Like I said, we're going to do more giveaways. We're going to do some shit. We just building a YouTube channel right now. But on the Apple, I ain't worried about the Apple because we charting every week still. Now we jump back in at top 100, top 200 globally. To wrap things up, man, I do wish that we had a sponsor for some weight loss shit. I don't know what the fuck new weight loss. I just know Jenny Craig. I don't know if anything else we can give that shit. We need to send some gift cards to your boy Sneak This.
Nah, like big boy, we for real, man. I got you. You know what I mean? 600-pound life. I lost 40 pounds, but I got you. You know what I'm saying? I feel you.
Hold on. Ozempic. Fat Joe just admitted he took Ozempic.
I ain't never did that, but you know, hey, it ain't going to get you nowhere, man, but I can help you lose some weight and feel great like Tony the Tiger. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, if I'm top three dweeb in the sneaker game, bro, could you imagine, dude, there's 500 million goofy mothers in the sneaker game, bro. And you could be up there in the top 1,000, bro. Because a lot of goofy motherfuckers out there.
And, bro, that's why they're called Sneak This, bro.
The audacity, bro, to look the way you look. And even, bro, you got to see the dude's Twitter profile picture, bro. It's like a cartoon picture. Because you know they ain't going to show that
motherfucker. A skinny version of him, right? A skinnier version
of
him.
Hell yeah, yeah, dog. You can't. Come on, bro. Come on, man. All right, anyways, y'all. We love y'all. We'll see y'all next Friday. We out, y'all. Peace.
This life that we live, man, it's cold as focus. Ice. We took a chance to fall, now we're setting the price.